Hi everyone, hopping on for another live broadcast. So today I want to talk with you about 6 ways to achieve tummy safe fitness. So a lot of my followers, people who have enrolled in my programs are women who are looking to strengthen their core after pregnancy, want to restore and recover diastasis, get their core and pelvic floor function back, all of that good stuff. So how do we translate that into taking it to the gym floor? That's what I want to talk with you about today. So we're talking again about 6 ways to achieve tummy safe fitness. So I'm going to talk some tips with you right now. So the first thing we want to keep in mind is you need to understand the importance of the transverse abdominis. Okay, so this is your deepest abdominal muscle. It starts at your rib cage and goes down to your pelvis, and it wraps around your torso almost like a corset. So in order to get that muscle, and it's also very important to learn how to engage and activate when it comes to correcting and fixing an abdominal separation post-pregnancy. So the biggest thing is you need to learn how to engage and contract your TVA. If you are sucking in your belly, you are pulling belly button to spine all the time, that is not teaching you how to properly engage your transverse abdominis or TVAs. We have to get you learning how to use those muscles in a way to help corset your spine and your pelvis so that they can better protect your spine and your pelvis when it comes to exercise and everyday movement. And I will also say that that is not going to happen by doing planks, sit-ups, crunches, leg lifts, knees to elbow, toes to bar, and all of those kinds of traditional core exercises. You need to first learn how to engage that TVA properly before you start adding on more exercise. And that's going to be another tip I'll talk about more in a few minutes. Next thing is you need to understand how to get your rib cage aligned over your pelvis. So starting to get my hands on top of each other. You need to learn how to get your rib cage stacked over your pelvis in a way where these two can work in a and can work in unison with one another. Your TVA, going back to that TVA muscle, your TVA is not able to engage and contract as well as we want it to, especially when we are relearning how to use our core and correct diastasis postpartum. The TVA does not work as well when you do not have your rib cage stacked over your pelvis like this, okay? And this is another key component to helping you correct any core and pelvic floor issues that you may be experiencing right now, okay? Hopefully you have noticed that I mentioned that it's not just the exercises that you do to help correct an abdominal separation. There are a lot more things we need to take into account when it comes to correcting core and pelvic floor issues. So we have to talk about getting your rib cage stacked over your pelvis. So rib cage line is horizontal with the floor. The top of your pelvis is horizontal with the floor. If you're here, that's never going to allow you to be able to fully access your TVA muscles. Okay. Tip number 3 is try and choose an upright position as much as you can when you are working out in the gym. Now, sometimes, again, it all goes back to managing intra-abdominal pressure well, and sometimes you may need to be on your back or you may need to be on all fours because that just feels better on your core than standing up. But most of the time, You want to try and pick an exercise where you are standing up, because if you think about it, standing up, being in an upright position, is a more functional position, and it translates over into our everyday activities. And that is when your TVA is easily activated when, remember that caveat, when you get your rib cage stacked over your hips properly, okay? So tip number three is getting yourself in an upright position so that you can learn to tap into your TVA muscles or your TVA muscle even more, okay? Tip number four is exhale on the hardest part of an exercise. Now, I know you may be thinking, breathing, you know, what's the big deal? Well, this is exactly it. Nobody ever teaches us how to breathe properly. And that's where many of us moms can get into trouble when it comes to healing abdominal separation, correcting abdominal separation, resolving any core and pelvic floor issues, is because nobody teaches us when we need to inhale, when we need to exhale, okay? So for right now, just keep in mind that you are always going to exhale on the hardest part of an exercise, okay? Remember, the core is designed to be long and stabilize the spine and pelvis. And I'm just saying this on a little side note. So when you do, and we're going back to the ribs over hips, when your ribs are not stacked over your hips properly, you cannot get your TVA in a nice long or elongated position, and so that it can wrap around and corset your spine and your pelvis. Many of us will get into these funky positions, and then that will cause us to either compensate by bracing. You know, you may have been in your exercise classes where your coach will tell you, okay, everybody brace. Brace like this, okay? And imagine someone is going to punch you in the stomach. That's how I want you to brace. Mm-mm. We have to brace from the inside. So you have to get yourself long and tall and learn how to activate your TVA muscle from the inside and keep that engaged to help protect your spine and your pelvis during exercise. And the other thing is your TVA engages on an exhale, not when you hold your breath or when you suck, as many coaches will say, suck belly button to spine. Your TVA does not engage when you are sucking your belly button to spine or when you are bracing, and in that brace, you're holding your breath. Your TVA engages when you exhale. So remember, exhale, exhale, exhale on the hardest part of an exercise. And I take it one step further with my clients and telling them to start your exhale before you move, okay? So let's say you're doing a squat. You go down into your squat. When you come up out of that squat, before you start to rise up out of your squat, start your exhale, continue exhaling as you stand up out of your squat, okay? Fifth step is simplify first. I like to use the analogy that your core is like the foundation of your house, and it pretty much is. Your house is your body. Your core is the foundation of your house, your body. Your core is your body's foundation. When you do not do the kind of restorative exercise that you need to do after baby to get your deeper core muscles back online, then your body finds ways to compensate and cheat to get the task at hand that you're asking it to do, okay? So if you have your baby and let's say you go to your 6-week checkup and your doctor tells you, all right, everything is great. Everything looks good. You can go back to resuming all normal activity. Not so fast. And I'm not saying you can't ever do the fun exercise that you want to get back into. You absolutely can. You just need to learn first how to engage those deeper core muscles first. And it has to be a step-by-step-by-step process where we are layering one piece of information, one piece of education on top of another so that you get it, okay? I do this with my clients all the time. When I have a mom that comes in to train with me in my studio or when I'm working with moms online, two of the biggest things that we will talk about first and foremost is getting your alignment, how you hold your body on a daily basis, getting your alignment in check, and getting your breathing mechanics in check. Once we have those two things, then we start to layer on engaging those deeper core muscles in timing with your breath. If you don't do that foundational work first, then your body is going to cheat. Your body loves to find the quickest way possible to get things done and the easiest way possible. So if your core is not functioning like it needs to, your body will then find a way to cheat to get the job done. And most likely that will come in ways of holding your breath, clenching your glutes, having crappy posture when you go to do different exercises, sucking in your belly. So really think about it. Next time you go to do workouts, I want you to slow down and really tune in to what your body is doing, because when done right, exercise is absolutely medicine, okay? It is absolutely one of the best medicines, if not the best, for getting your body to feel and function as well as it can be. But when you do it in a way where you start to get sloppy, you're not paying attention to what you're doing, and form goes out the window, that's when we get into trouble, and that's when core and pelvic floor symptoms can rear their ugly heads. So you have to get your foundation set first and learn simple things, simple tasks first, like engaging those muscles before heading into any kind of boot camp or CrossFit class. So this is what I want you to keep in mind. If you are a mom who likes to do high intensity exercise, ask yourself, when you step into the door of your gym, is your coach going through these kinds of things with you? Is your trainer working through these kinds of things with you? Are they telling you that you need to get your alignment in check, your breathing mechanics in check? Are they watching how you engage your core so that your body is ready to move on to more intense exercise? Okay, let me see, we have a question. I feel like even before getting pregnant and having a child, I didn't really know how to hold my core tight and whatever. Yeah, it's true, Jennifer. Most of us don't, we're never really taught how to engage. And I go through all of this in, well, you'll get a taste of it in my challenge coming up, but I go through all of this with my moms in my 8-week core and pelvic floor program because we need to know this. Like, we need to get this right before we layer on, you know, the heavy deadlifts, the heavy squats, the running, the jumping, all of that stuff, okay? And then tip number 6 is you need to know the difference between multitasking and compensating, okay? Compensating is a survival technique for the body. It's not a strengthening technique. So ask yourself this question. Like, let's say I always mention CrossFit because I was in the CrossFit background for a very long time. I like to do high intensity exercise on, you know, an occasional basis, not as much as I used to. So ask yourself this question. When you go to do something like a squat and a press, or if you're in the CrossFit world, if you go to do a thruster, pay attention to what you're doing with your body, okay? That is a multitasking movement. You're using your lower body and your upper body at the same time. But can you do it properly? Can you still do that thruster and still engage your core properly and exhale during the right time? If not, you need to kind of pull the reins back in and reevaluate if that movement or these multifunctional or multi-tasking movements, multi-joint movements, are appropriate for where your body is at right now in your season of motherhood. And not just motherhood, your season of life right now, okay? If you are compensating, again, that is a survival strategy. So if we're going back to our thruster analogy or example, if you're holding your breath, if you're bracing, if your alignment gets really crappy when you come up out of the hole in that thruster and you're overarching to try and get the bar overhead or the dumbbells overhead, this is a compensatory strategy. It is not your body being able to multitask. So we need to be able to teach the body to multitask well so that we're not always experiencing injuries and issues down the line, okay? Another question, can I do these workouts for the kickstart at home? I don't have a gym. Absolutely, you can absolutely do the workouts in the kickstart challenge at home. The core workouts only require a few, just like two or three pieces of equipment that you can all use at home. Same thing with my membership program. All of my workouts are created to either be done at home or in the gym. But I still always also suggest that my clients build up some kind of nice little home gym with a variety of equipment, because you can't, if you want to see any sort of gains, you have to see, or if you want to see any sort of gains, you have to progressively overload the body. You can't just keep doing body weight exercises over and over and over again. You can't just see keep working out with the same amount of weight over and over and over again. If you want to see more muscle tone, more muscle definition, aerobic endurance increase, core strength increased, all that good stuff, you have to progressively, keyword, progressively overload the body. And that means getting yourself a few pairs of dumbbells at different weights and just some other little things to have at home, okay? So those are my tips for today. So let me recap them. Number one, understand the importance of the TVA muscles and how they activate and engage. Number two, choose a neutral pelvis and a neutral rib cage alignment in order for that TVA muscle to activate well. I will say that there is a very well-known physical therapist in the CrossFit world that is always telling women that they don't need to worry as much about their alignment. And I have to say that I completely disagree with that, because yes, your body needs to be able to move and get in and out of different positions, but especially when you are a woman who is learning how to heal your core and your pelvic floor, we have to get you in the position that is the most favorable for your core to come back online, okay? So we want you to be practicing, and it helps keep you as injury-free as possible so that when you go into your everyday movements, you're protecting that spine and your pelvis, because it's little things that we do through the long haul, these little lifestyle habits that we do over and over and over again that add up to a big difference. Like if you're someone that's always doing this to unload the dishwasher, you are compressing your lower spine. We have to get you in a better position so that you're using your glutes and your hamstrings and you're getting your rib cage stacked over your pelvis to manage intra-abdominal pressure better. I feel I have good posture, so I don't know. From videos I see, I have my ribs stacked during all my workouts. Okay, you could be, but sometimes it takes a very keen eye to see what's going on, because it could be one little tweak that you're not noticing that we need to adjust to get you into a more favorable position. So take a video of yourself and see what's happening. And if you want to, send it to me and I'll take a look at it and I can give you some feedback. Where were we? So number three, choose upright postures to help engage that TVA more. Remember I mentioned earlier that your TVA, because gravity is in the mix, your body has to respond to the pull of gravity. So the TVA will kick in faster when you are in upright position, because it needs to stabilize the spine and the pelvis and the body in an upright posture, okay? Number four, exhale on the hardest part of an exercise. And I won't just say an exercise, I will say everyday movement, okay? This is a biggie with me and my clients. This is where we help fix everyday lifestyle habits, because again, it's not just what you do in the gym, it's what you do the other 95% of the day that will affect whether or not your core and pelvic floor is coming back online and engaging better and strengthening so that you can get back to the activities that you enjoy without pain or annoyance or stress or all of that stuff, okay? So whenever you go to do an exercise, exhale on the hardest part of the exercise. Remember the squat. You inhale on the way down, exhale on the way up. Okay. Same thing for everyday movements. If your baby or your kiddo is on the floor and you need to get them off the floor, if you're getting them out of the crib or lifting everyday items like a bag of groceries, your suitcase, whatever. When you go to lift, inhale to set your core. Exhale while you lift up your item or your child. Okay. Tip number five, simplify first. And this is where making sure that you do restorative type programs for your core postpartum. And I don't care what stage postpartum you are. It doesn't just apply to moms who are around the 6 week mark. It applies to moms who are 3, 5, 10, 15 years postpartum, because most likely you did not do anything or the correct type of things to restore your core postpartum. Most likely, again, because we're not really told these things. We're not told exactly what to do. You probably just jumped back into exercise and doing all the planks and all the sit-ups and all the leg raises and all that stuff to try and strengthen your core. But the deal is those exercises only strengthen your superficial muscles. We have to target those deeper muscles, and we do that with breath work and alignment. Okay. Number six, know the difference between multitasking and compensating. So take inventory of your movements. Notice if you are able to do them without any compensating through the body, with your posture not getting, or I should say your alignment, with your alignment not getting jacked up, where you're not like tucking your tailbone underneath all the time, or you're scrunching down on your core, or you're holding your breath, or you're overarching like this, okay? You have to take all of those things into accountability. And yes, as the weight gets heavier, you probably will start to compensate a little bit more, but let's get you stronger out of the gate so that when you build up to the heavier weights and more intense exercise, you know what to be aware of and what you need to do with your body. Okay. So wrapping up, if you don't know what your TVA is, if you can't figure out what your alignment looks like, if you have no clue how to properly engage your deeper core muscles, if you are starting to, a light bulb is going off and you're starting to realize that you're compensating on a lot of your exercises, breath holding is a huge compensatory tactic for the body. Also, clenching your glutes is a huge compensatory tactic when you lack the core strength. So if you are a mom who has never done anything to correct what's going on with your core, our body, again, likes to cheat. So it will do this. You'll do this with your glutes, and you'll be clenching your glutes. And oftentimes, you're probably doing it, and you're not realizing that you're doing it. But if you're doing this, this is your body trying to create a false sense of stability because your core foundation isn't doing what it needs to be doing, okay? And if you need help with following these guidelines, or if you need help getting your core back online after baby, then I strongly encourage you to sign up for my Postpartum Kickstart Challenge. This is not just another challenge where you are being given a bunch of different core exercises to do and that's it. Yes, I give you core exercises that you can do at home, and they are less than 10 minutes. The biggest thing I hear from moms is, I don't have time. I'm going to be real with you. You do have time. You're not prioritizing yourself. You are not prioritizing your time properly so that you can get it done for you. You have 10 minutes to get these workouts in. You spend 10 minutes on the phone scrolling through your Instagram feed and your Facebook feed. That's 10 minutes that you could have used to get a workout done for yourself, and you owe it to yourself, okay? So these workouts, yes, I do give you core workouts that you can do at home, but the biggie about this challenge is that I also teach you about all these other underlying things that you need to keep in mind when it comes to restoring your core after baby that a lot of other challenges or programs don't take into account, okay? So the link for joining the challenge is in the description. We have over 100 women that have signed up for this challenge. So if you have signed up for the challenge and you are not in the Facebook group yet, I sent an email out earlier. Click on the link, get yourself in the Facebook group, because I will also be giving out a prize every day of the challenge. This is going to be awesome. You are going to learn a lot. The women who went through it last time were so appreciative and so happy, and they were feeling stronger through their core within just a few days, okay? So that is it for today, everyone. Thank you so much for joining in and listening to this little chat with you. And thank you so much for hopping in and answer or asking questions, okay? I love the interaction. So if you have any more questions, you can always message me on Facebook at Fit to Her Core or on Instagram at Fit to Her Core, or you can send me an email at info@fittoHerCore.com. And I will see you guys later. Bye.